Hey everyone, welcome to Relatively Refined. My name is Paula. I have some puppies down here at my feet, as always, and there's one back there waiting on a treat. But it is the end of August, and that means it is time for our thrift find of the month. And today's video is a little bit different, and we have a couple of surprises. So let's go ahead and get started with our August thrift find of the month.
Hey everyone, and welcome to the August edition of our thrift find of the month. So my thrift find this month is really a two-parter. So the first part of it I got at a yarn sale. And what I got are these four glasses. They're vintage from the 1960s, Peanuts glasses that were a promotion at McDonald's. You can see it's got the McDonald's logo right here. And apparently there's a set of five. This particular yard sale had four of them for $10, so I got the four. It's got Lucy here saying, "There's no excuse for not properly being prepared." And there's Sally carrying all of this stuff. It's got Charlie Brown saying, "Rats, why is having fun always so much work?" It's got Snoopy saying, "Civilization is overrated." And it has Snoopy again saying, "Morning people are hard to love." And it's got Woodstock up there. Blah. And so I picked up the four of these, and they're in perfect shape. They're vintage. They're from the 1960s when McDonald's was giving away, you know, glasses, real glasses. And then I did a little reading about it, and there is a fifth one where Linus has the speech bubble. And I was able to find that one very easily on eBay, and I picked it up for $3. It just hasn't arrived yet. And so I got the five of them for $13. But what makes this thrift find really cool is apparently there is the Holy Grail sixth glass that is very elusive and very hard to find. And it was the promotional glass that was originally sent to McDonald's, getting them, you know, trying to get them interested in carrying these glasses, which obviously it worked. And, but as I read about it, the characters on it don't really look like the Peanuts character. Somebody else did the promotional one, so they look a little funny. And it's got, you know, like, happiness is 30 years of being on the Snoopy cartoons or something like that. So half the fun will be to be on the hunt and look for that sixth glass that apparently has gone, you know, upwards of $350 on eBay. I have no intention of, you know, scouring the ends of the earth to find it in order to sell it. I just thought it'd be a really cool thing to have all six of them, and they will be a gift to my son, who happens to be a big Peanuts fan. But part of thrifting is to be on the hunt for something, and this will be a really fun one to look to keep an eye out for at various thrift shops, yard sales, junk shops, wherever. And who knows, it may just show up. So the Peanuts glasses, the McDonald's promotional vintage Peanut glasses from the 1960s, a set of five, collected in two different places for $13 total, is my August thrift find of the month.
Hey everybody, I am coming to you from my classroom. It is the end of a long day at school, so I'm probably looking a little worse for the wear, but I'm here in my classroom because my thrift find of the month is now living in my classroom. So let me go ahead and flip the camera around and give you a tour of the thrift find as well as of my classroom. My thrift find of the month is this beautiful upholstered rocking chair that I found at my local Goodwill, the one that is right near school, for $24.99. This chair is in absolutely perfect condition. It doesn't have a stain, a mark, a scratch, a tear, anything. It's absolutely perfect. And when I saw it, I knew that it would be the perfect chair for my circle time. This is the area on the rug where the students gather, and I'll sit in the chair and read to them, or we may have a small lesson. But it is so comfortable, and it's beautiful enough to keep in my own home. Here is a little look at my classroom. Those of you who have been following the channel for a while know that I am an elementary school counselor, and I am lucky enough to have my own classroom. So I thought while we're here, I'd give you a little look around. It's set up like most classrooms. On the wall to the left when you walk in the room is a bank of cupboards and storage, and there's my sink area. I also have a microwave and coffee maker for me, and then I have an ice maker, not for drinks, but for making up little ice packs to treat any boo-boos or bumps that kids may get. This area is the Happy Camper area, and I have some chairs set up for kids to sit in and gather, and then I have a tent, which I got at a yard sale, and in the tent is a blanket and a weighted blanket. And that's where some kids can come if they are, you know, kind of worked up or upset. They maybe want to just chill out or calm down and get control of themselves. They can go in that tent and just get themselves together. And then I have some shelves with books and toys on them. And then here's another little sitting area. This is an area where I can hold a small group, or kids can just gather to talk or meet with me. I have some rainbow bins with stuffed animals and other things in them. And then on that wall, on the back of the classroom, is my cubby area where I store all kinds of things, and I have some books and posters and such on display. So when I saw this gorgeous rocking chair, I knew that it would be the perfect addition to my classroom, and I have already sat in it and read some of my favorite books like Enemy Pie and How Full Is Your Bucket. So for $24.99, this gorgeous rocking chair is my thrift find of the month for August.
Hi, this is Patty with my August thrift find of the month. I was so happy to find this set of Waterford toasting champagne flutes on the Facebook marketplace. I have been eyeing these for some time for an anniversary gift for a special couple, and they do come on quite frequently on the Facebook marketplace, and they typically in my area hover between $65 and $100 for the set. And so there was one pair that I was looking at in particular because they were new in box with stickers and they were $65. And then I got a notice that there was a price change and they dropped to $10 for the pair. So I immediately made the connection and was able to pick them up. They were just in the next town over. And what I love about these is they have, even though they were originally made for ringing in the new year, they have symbols on the sides. There's five symbols that make it really appropriate for any celebration. There is happiness, love, prosperity, health, and peace. So I think that any of those would make a great message for any celebration. So I think these will be perfect for an anniversary. And I love Waterford Crystal. You can see they still have the stickers, the iconic seahorse sticker, and the etching that says Waterford. And they are beautiful. They're tall. They're about a foot tall, I believe. They might be just shy of 12 inches tall, and they are beautiful. This particular set, however, is relatively new, and so these are made in Germany. Unfortunately, I had really wanted ones that were made in Ireland, but now they are not. I think they are typically made in other parts of the world, but they are still heavy and beautiful, and for $10 with the box, these are going to be a perfect anniversary gift for a very special couple, and I got these for $10 on the Facebook marketplace. It really does pay to be patient know what you're looking for, and to be ready to pounce when the price is right.
And now we have some bonus footage. This is a thrift haul that Kathleen filmed this summer, and somehow we missed it, so I wanted to be sure to include it. So here is Kathleen's long-lost mid-summer thrift haul.
Hey friends, it's Kathleen. Here we are, just about halfway through summer. And if you've been watching Relatively Refined lately, you'll know that our sister Paula has been on a roll. She has had incredible luck at her local thrift stores and Goodwills where she is down in South Carolina. Here in Vermont, not so much, but throughout the summer so far, I have made a few trips. I try to go somewhat regularly, and I've picked up a few things along the way. And so today I gathered all of my treasures from trips throughout the summer and thought I would share with you in this haul. So today's video is a haul of those purchases. So what we're going to do is we're going to start small and work our way toward the biggest item. So the smallest item that I got is this adorable little Christmas ornament. And it's one of those Swedish looking ornaments that I've picked up before as well. And this one is a little skier, and I got that for $1. It's unusual to find Christmas decor out in the thrift stores right now, but at the Goodwill they have a section of holiday, a whole aisle of holiday, and that was there, so I did pick that up. I also picked up a set of six of these. They're just cloth placemats. I don't know if they're, it's called from India Overseas. Just a really pretty periwinkle blue, and I will use these out on our outdoor table because it's the metal table out on the patio, and it has an umbrella, so there's a hole in the middle, so I can't use a tablecloth. So I use cloth placemats, and there was a whole set of six of those. So that was good. That will come in handy. The next thing that I got is totally decor. It used to work, used to be probably fairly functional, and it's this old vintage fan, and it's not electrified, it's been pulled apart, but it has such a cool sculptural look to it. It's heavy, and I really wouldn't want it to work because these things look like they are deadly to anybody's fingers should they get stuck in there. But I just put it on a side table. It's going to be hot next week, and it just gives sort of the appearance of a fan going, but I just like the sculptural element of it and the vintageness of it. I thought it was kind of cool. So I did pick that up, and that will just be decor. I did get this, fairly large basket. It's actually pretty big. It is big. You know, it's kind of a flexible, it's not really stiff or sturdy, but it's really beautiful. Again, it has a nice texture to it. It's a woven material. I don't know. Oh, it even has a ticket on the bottom. It doesn't say how much it originally was. It's not old or anything. I'm not sure where it came from, but for a couple of bucks, I'm not even actually sure what I'm going to do with it. I have a set of hand weights that I keep out, and I may try to just disguise them in this basket so that they're not just stuck underneath the table. So that was kind of a cool find. Sometimes those are nice to have. It's also, it could be a market basket. It's got the handle, so you could take it to the farmer's market or even in your own garden if you have enough to pick from. I did get some clothing. So let me share with you some of the pieces of clothing that I got. This isn't clothing, but it's a blue, leather blue pocketbook. Very soft leather, and actually the woman told me that I could just have this for free because the bottom looked dirty. Doesn't look too bad to me. I don't think it's anything fancy, but I needed a summer pocketbook. It's called Susan Joy or Joy something. It is leather. It's a soft leather, and I liked the color of it because right now I'm still carrying around my dark brownish black pocketbook, and I thought it would be nice. I have a lot of white clothing for summer, some linens, and I thought this might be nice to have. And it's a nice size. It can hold enough. I don't like them too big, but I don't like them too small. So I did pick up that for free. The clothing. So a friend of mine is trying to get me into pickleball and a little bit of golf. So I picked up this very cute little golf shirt, women's golf shirt, and the clothing, these all came from the local thrift store, and it's in mint condition. I mean, there's like not a mark. It's as crisp white as could be. And then along with that was this cute little golf teeny skirt. So I have a new golf outfit when I want to go golfing with her. But I really liked it. And actually, you don't have to wear this golf. You could put it with a regular old white t-shirt and it would look perfectly fine. But it's cute and it has a nice collar. And it's one of those athletic ones. So it has the built-in shorts underneath it, which is nice for playing sports, pickleball or golf. So that I picked up. I told you I would like to wear white in the summer. I did pick up this white, it's like a blouse. It's an athleta, just a white, but on the back it has this brown and kind of pinkishy stripe down the back. But otherwise it's just a plain, in need of ironing. I washed it, but I haven't ironed it. Just a plain white shirt for summer. I got, let's see, a pair of shorts. These are Patagonia, women's Patagonia shorts. These, I mean, these are expensive. These are quality shorts. They don't really fit. I didn't try those on. As a matter of fact, I wrote up a blog post about buying clothes. And one of my tips was to, know your size and when in doubt, try it on. Well, I didn't even follow my own advice. And I got these because I know the brand and I had a feeling they might be a little bit too big and they are. So I will probably either redonate these or, put them on our local marketplace and see if somebody can use them. And another one of my tips on the blog post is to always look for, be a label shopper. Look for the names you know. And I did pick up this. It's a men's shirt. I got it for my son. Summer shirts, very summer weight. And it's a Tommy Bahama. And I know where my mom lives in Florida, there's a store there and they're very expensive, like to buy brand new. So this is there's no marks on it or anything, but it has that sort of worn in feeling to it. And it's a nice, almost like a seersucker, like a pinstriped shirt. So I'll send that up to him. For summer. Let's see. My next find is we purchased in Maine when we were on our trip. I think my sister Patty shared with you a video about our trip to Maine. Our mom was there for a couple weeks and each of us went at different times to spend a little time with her and get a little break from where we live. So we did some thrifting as well. And I got, or she got for me, she actually got this for me, this cool candle holder. And it's one of those ones that you can see it folds in and then it folds out. I have to get some candles. I only had two in my house that would fit. So I stuck them in there. But this was only $5. And I love this. Paula has her teapots. Patty has her hurricane lamp and her blue, her china. And I have candle holders and I just have a thing for those. What I like about them is they don't take up all that much room. This is a big one and I have it set out. You can see the table behind me is missing something and that's where I put this on that table. And I absolutely love it. I do want to get some matching candles because I only had the two in my candle drawer. The last item that I got at the Goodwill just the other day. That was the latest find that I had. And I'm going to stop the camera and turn it around so you can see it because I can't hold it all up. But I was perusing the aisle and I spotted a set. It looks like a set of four of of dishes, and it caught my eye because I'm like, oh, that really is, that looks, has that vintage, you know, when something just looks vintage and you know it was probably kind of a cool company. So I turned it over, and sure enough, it was Franciscan earthenware. And I looked it up, and it was called the Daisy Pattern. And it was from, probably, I think it said from 1960 to 1966. So somebody had these in their house and donated them to the Goodwill. And it was marked, the whole set was marked $28, but it had a green ticket. And the day that I was there, anything that had a green ticket was 50% off. So I did buy the whole set for $14. And let me turn the camera around and show you what was part of that set. So you can see it's a fairly large set, and it's called the Daisy Pattern. And it came with four plates, four of these small bowls, four saucers underneath the bowls. It's all taped up. I haven't even untaped it. And then four like salad plates underneath that. There are the little cups that go on the saucers, even a little salt and pepper, and some larger bowls, a little gravy boat with the attached, and you can see it's Franciscan earthenware. This little pitcher, which would look great with flowers in it, or it's just so pretty. But the sort of the main piece here is this coffee pot. And it's all, there's not a chip or a mark on anything. It's amazing that this set has survived that many years. Actually, it's as old as I am. So I won't tell you how old that is. But I looked up, I did do a quick lookup on eBay because I wasn't sure, you know, if this was anything. And they didn't have a whole set like this. But what they did have was the coffee pot, and the coffee pot was listed at $85. So I don't know what the whole set is valued at. Somebody who collects it would probably love to have it. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with it. But for $14, I had to put it in my cart and take it home. And I forgot one piece of clothing that I did get. I told you I like white, and I like that sort of blouse look. Well, this is a long, it's like a dress. You can see it goes all the way down. And I bought it with the intent of a bathing suit cover-up, because I thought, oh, it would be nice if it's really hot. It covers your arms, you know, so it protects you a little bit from the sun. And I got it home. I didn't recognize the brand, ASOS Design. And I got it home, and I was washing, and I bleached it and washed it and hung it outside. And I noticed it said it was a maternity shirt. So I don't care, because all it means is just I'm using it as a beach cover up. But apparently it was a maternity dress at one point in time. But I'm going to use it for the beach cover up. So anyway, so here we are halfway through the summer. That is what I have picked up thus far, starting from when school got out in June. And I will continue to pop in and peek in at thrift stores. Our local one, it's kind of nice because during the school year, I have a hard time getting there because of the hours. They close by the time I can get back home. So it's been kind of fun to be able to poke in and see what's there. And the inventory changes every single day. The woman told me they get so many donations, and it's just a constant cycle of in and out. So I'll continue to pop in and see what they have for this summer. And then just before school starts, I'll share with you sort of my second half of summer haul. Hopefully it will be good. This was not a lot, but what I like about it is that everything is usable, and I will put it right to use. So thank you for watching. I hope you liked something in the haul. It's kind of fun. I hope you've had some good luck thrifting. Like I said, Paula has had amazing luck. Ours, Patty and I have had less good luck. But overall, you know, you never know. So I'm going to keep at it until the end of summer. Thank you for watching. As I said, if you haven't subscribed, please do. We're getting awfully close to that 5,000 number of subscribers. And if you stick around, you can see an episode of our Relatively Refines where one of our viewers shares something that they found in their thrifting adventures. All right, until the next video, take care.
And now we are wrapping up this video with our Relatively Refines segment where we share some of our viewers' thrifted treasures. Today's treasure comes from our viewer, Melanie. Melanie was coming to the Lowcountry where I live for a vacation and asked me for some suggestions for thrift shops. And I gave her some and she followed up and she found all of these beautiful treasures that you will see at one Goodwill. She said the unifying theme of all of her treasures is pink. She loves the color pink. She loves that floral vase we just saw and this gorgeous serving tray. She said she can imagine having a cheese ball at one end and crackers at the other. All of these beautiful finds, Melanie, are things that I would have picked up myself. So you beat me to it. And I'm so glad that you were able to come and enjoy your trip to the Lowcountry and also to get some of these beautiful treasures at a great price. So thank you so much, Melanie, for sharing these treasures. If you would like us to feature one of your thrifted treasures or several of your thrifted treasures, simply send us an email to the address on the screen with a picture and an explanation, and we will be glad to feature it in an upcoming video. All right, everyone, that's going to do it for today. Thank you so much for joining us for our Thrift Find of the Month, Kathleen's Long Lost Thrift Haul, and our Relatively Refined. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up, share it to some of your friends who may be interested in this kind of content, and be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. We will see you all in the next video. Take care and bye-bye.